Yeah, I don't know how many of y'all ever had these brooms where after a while, like all the ends are frayed, so all the dust and dog hair just sticks in it, and so you can't really sweep up properly. What I'm doing today is actually trimming my broom. I'm giving it a little bit of a haircut to get back down to the areas where the bristles are just really uniform. And my grandmother used to teach me to do this, so she would have brooms for quite a while, and you have to turn the broom so that it don't all like be leaning on one side and stuff like that while you're sweeping. But I'm trimming my broom today so this broom will last longer. But I also hopefully will be learning how to make brooms from palms and stuff soon, so then I wouldn't actually have to buy a broom and reduce the amount of plastic that I put into the environment. But this is one of the ways that I don't have to buy a whole new broom and keep this broom a little bit longer so that it can last for me. Also there's the issue that every time I cut it, I'm making little pieces of plastic that are smaller and also separating them out so that they get more into the environment, which is a challenge for me because, you know, microplastics are a big issue in the ocean. But I do try to make sure that all of my waste, that's plastic waste or that's not compostable, ends up directly in the dump. And, you know, being involved in discussions that help us to reform how we manage our waste in the Bahamas. So all those things are really important at different levels for reducing the amount of plastic that I use, making sure that it's disposed of properly, and then helping to make sure that our country really handles that waste in the appropriate manner. So I hope you all enjoyed that little bit of science and perspective. I have to go and finish trimming this broom and then sweep. Y'all have a great day. Bye.